Italy has triggered a diplomatic dispute by announcing that the two Italian Marines accused of killing two Indian fishermen will not return to India. And the Marines were allowed to return home for the second time in the last 3 months to vote in the elections there after signing an undertaking here with the Supreme Court that they would be returning back to India to face the trial. The question now is, will the government now take up this breach of trust internationally?
The two Italian mariners who were responsible for killing of a fisherman off the coast of Kerala were given permission by the Supreme Court to go back for the elections in Italy. It's learned that the Italian government has refused to hand them back, and they had been taken under the bond given by the ambassador of Italy to India. It's a betrayal. It's sort of a bluff by the Italian government. And it's also a bluff to the highest court of land, which is the Supreme Court, which was generous enough to allow them to go abroad under diplomatic considerations. But the question arises here that there was apprehension expressed even by the Chief Minister of Kerala that the mariners will not come back. Despite that, the Supreme Court did give an option for them to go back. But having said that, a big question arises. Why does the Italian government take India so casual? Why does it think that India is a banana republic where they can take liberties like this and a unilateral betrayal of faith between two sovereign nations? This is a big question which the Indian government would have to answer. The Bharatiya Janata Party would demand that in the interest of justice, the fugitives, the sailors who have escaped, should be brought back and tried under the Indian law in Indian courts as early as possible.
Do you think government... Well, let's see what they have said, not respond to you. Let's respond to what they have said. I haven't even been to the office. Let me get back to my office. I know it's a Supreme Court decision, but it's also a matter of our country's collective decision. We can't pass the ball on it to anybody. Let's just read what is said. Let's understand their position, and we will respond. We'll let you know what exactly. We'll read the papers first. First things first. Let us see what they have to say and why, what their reasoning is. After all, they went last time, came back, they've gone again, and they have sent us a letter. Let's read the letter, see what the reasoning is, and then we'll respond. We'll certainly take you on board.
A shameful thing happened in the last night. It is a shame that a country which is proclaimed to be the biggest sovereign democratic republic, like a country like India, is subjugated to the needs and ambitions of a small country like Italy, which is dominated by this mafia don. And it is a shame too, these two issues are raised. We have raised two issues. One is that of the life and livelihood of fishermen. Second aspect is that of India's sovereignty and India's patriotism. These two things are challenged.
Sir, a diplomatic failure hai. भारत सरकार को चाहिए कि इस पर सख्त रवैया अपनाए. हमारे देश के लोगों को मारकर भारत के कानून के मुताबिक जिनकी गिरफ्तारी हुई थी उनको जिस तरह से भेजा गया, सरकार को इस पर जवाब देना होगा. संसद में भी हम ये सवाल सरकार से पूछेंगे कि आखिर इटालियन मैरीन को किस परिस्थिति में पैरोल पे भेजा गया, और जब भेजा गया तो उसकी गारंटी उस वक्त की इटालियन सरकार ने दी थी क्या, और फिर वहां इटालियन सरकार इस बात का भी जवाब उसको देना पड़ेगा कि आखिर जब भारत के संविधान के अनुसार ये लॉ ऑफ लैंड जो है इसके तहत जो मुकदमा चल रहा है उसमें उस मुजरिम को वापस आना ही पड़ता है, और इसके लिए कांग्रेस की सरकार को जवाब देना होगा कि आखिर इटालियन मैरीन पर मेहरबान क्यों है यूपीए की सरकार, आखिर इसके पीछे साजिश क्या थी, क्या ये सोची समझी रणनीति का हिस्सा तो नहीं था, क्या इटालियन गवर्नमेंट और भारत सरकार के बीच में पहले इस बारे में कोई बात हुई थी क्या. भारतीय जनता पार्टी ये जानना चाहती है कि सरकार उस पर दबाव क्यों नहीं बना रही. इसलिए किसी भी शर्त पर इसमें चूक नहीं होनी चाहिए, भारत सरकार को इटली सरकार पर दबाव बनाना चाहिए और इटालियन मेरीन को वापस यहां बुलाकर भारत के कानून के हिसाब से मुकदमा चलाना चाहिए।